following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
Hi, Gordon.
Hi, Bob.
How you doing?
Whose cat?
I don't know. It's just a stray cat that's been living around Sesame Street, and nobody knows its name, so we just call it Cat.
You call it Cat.
Right.
That's very clever.
You know, we usually put out a saucer of milk for it, and it didn't come to eat today.
Cat.
You want to help us look for it, honey?
Oh, are you serious? Do you know I am the best, number one, top cat catcher on Sesame Street?
No, I never knew that.
You never knew that?
No.
Well, you watch. I'll find it for you.
Oh. Hi, Gordon.
Hey, Big Bird, how are you?
Oh, buddy.
Listen, we've lost a cat on Sesame Street. Yeah. Cat, and we want you to help us find it.
Good heavens. A cat lost here on Sesame Street.
Right, a cat.
That's terrible.
Why don't you take up, go up by the store and look for it.
Okay,
I'll look around here.
I'll look, Gordon. Here, cat. Here, cat. Here, cat.
Here, cat.
Here, cat. Here,
cat. Cat.
Here, cat. Here, cat. I didn't want to tell him. I don't know what a cat looks like. I hope he's small and friendly and not huge and frightening. Oh, here, cat. Here, cat. Here, cat. Here, cat.
1, 2, 3, 4, close the window, shut the door.
Ernie?
1, 2, 3, 4, paint the ceiling, scrub the floor.
Hey, Ernie, what are you doing?
1, 2, what'd you say, Bert?
I said, what are you
doing? 3, 4. I'm a football player, Bert. I'm giving the team cheer.
You're a football player?
Hoop. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fight the battle. Win the war.
All right, all right. Now, if you're a football player, tell me, what is your team called, huh?
Oh, we're called the Dirty Rugs, Bert.
The Dirty Rugs?
Hoop. Hoop.
Now, why would any team call itself the Dirty Rugs, huh?
Because everybody's always beating us. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hoop.
Susan, I have looked from the roof to the basement, all over this building, and I still can't find that cat.
No luck, huh?
No, but don't worry about him. He'll show up someplace.
I'm not worried.
You're not worried?
No.
Susan.
Hmm?
Have you looked at this table?
I was just over there to set it, honey.
Yeah, do you see anything wrong?
I've got 3 knives instead of 1.
Yeah.
Oh, and I turned my soup bowls upside down. I put milk in the saucers.
And you're not worried, right? Yeah, two salt shakers instead of a salt and pepper.
I do.
But what else were you going to have for lunch?
Well, I was going to make some toast, and then we can eat.
Okay, let me do it, okay?
Okay, thanks.
All right. Because you're still worried about that cat. That's pretty obvious.
Well.
So,
just
toast started, and,
You didn't put the bread in the toaster.
Yeah, I didn't. Well, I guess we're both still a little worried about the cat, huh?
Hey, Bert.
Yeah?
Hey, come here, Bert.
Yeah, what, Ernie?
Hey, look, my friend here has a quiz.
Your friend?
Yes. Now, take a look at the dog
here. Yeah?
And tell me, how many feet does the dog have?
It's got 4 feet. Anybody can see that, Ernie.
Oh, that's very good, Bert.
Yeah?
But they get harder after that. Yes. Now take a look at this next one.
Yeah.
And now look at the table and tell me how many legs does the table have?
Oh, Ernie, this is all so easy.
Now, no hints, Bert. How many?
4 legs, of course.
Hey, that's very nice. Right. Next card. Okay, now they get harder after that, don't
you see?
I
hope so.
Yes, now take a look at this next one.
Yeah?
And now tell me, how many eyes can you count on this face?
Oh, now, wait a minute, Ernie. Now, nobody looks like that.
Now, how many eyes, Bert?
Well, 4 eyes, Ernie, but nobody...
Hey, you're absolutely right.
Now, Ernie, nothing in the world has 4 eyes and looks like that. I mean, that's the ugliest, most awful-looking, disgusting creature that I have ever On the other hand, I can see in your friend's eyes he's very gentle, and I hope very slow.
The cat's around here somewhere. Where is it? Cat? Oh, Mr. Cardwell, you haven't seen a cat around here, have you?
A cat?
Yeah, I don't even know how to describe it, except it's a cat, and it's lost.
Well, there's... didn't see a cat, but lots of triangles.
Lots of triangles?
Triangles. Triangles are everywhere. There's one over there.
Hey, that is a triangle, but it just came out of the air.
Well, I've been finding them everywhere.
Like where?
Well, there might even be one in here.
Oh.
There's another one.
Yeah.
Hey, that's my triangle.
Who's that?
That's Oscar. Don't worry about him. He lives there in a trash can, and he doesn't like to share anything with anybody. But these triangles, where are they coming from?
Well, I've just been finding them in the air. There's one over here.
That's another triangle.
They're everywhere. Look, there's one there.
Yeah. Oh, wait a minute. Now, triangles just don't pop up all over Sesame Street.
Well, the air's filled with them. There's another one over there.
Oh, come on. That's... the triangles every... where are you getting them from? They just pop up another triangle.
Look, there's another one.
Another triangle.
See, I told
just
you.
Came
there's
out of the air on Sesame Street.
Well, they're everywhere.
Where?
Look, right there.
Now, wait a minute. This is just a little bit too much. Triangles just don't come out.
Well, there's triangles all over. What? Well, there's one in your ear.
What?
And there's another one behind your leg. And there's one behind your shoulder.
Behind my...
And there's another one in the air. Filled with triangles.
Well, thanks a lot.
You're welcome. Yeah, if you ever lose a triangular cat, just call on me.
Yeah.
Where'd you get all those triangles?
I don't know. Where'd you get a monkey?
Oh, I just picked up a monkey. Isn't he cute?
Yeah? It's pretty cute. Look at him. He's eating a peanut.
Yeah, I just gave him one.
Let's give him peanut shells. You better take him over here.
Let's sit him down.
Sit down. See if he'll come down here. You
have
another peanut?
Yeah. They come down out of trees for food. Let's see if he'll come down out of my back for this one.
He talks a lot.
Would you like another one? Come on down. Yep.
Yeah, he did come down.
Isn't he cute?
Yeah, he's taking a nap or something.
This is a little South American monkey. It's called a capuchin monkey.
Yeah. What about the tail? It's a pretty long... He just wrapped his tail around my finger. How about that?
He just went home.
Where are you going?
Yeah,
he
likes you.
He does?
Yeah.
Does he have a name?
It's
Cappuccini.
Cappuccini.
Oh, monkey, don't say things like that. That's terribly unkind to say. That's
he,
better.
That's
better. Look at his eye teeth.
Wow,
you notice that?
Yeah, he's got nice
teeth.
He's
got eye teeth at the bottom. And
I wonder if he brushes his teeth every morning, huh?
He probably does with a peanut shell. Okay. He's active.
He can really, swing by his tail, you know.
He can?
Yeah. Some monkeys are real swingers, you know.
They're swinging monkey.
Right. It's called a prehensile tail, the swing by. See him hang on to
it? He doesn't swing by that chain, then.
No, he doesn't swing by his
chain. He swings by the tail.
Yeah. They eat a lot of fruits and insects and all kinds of things. But they love to swing.
He does, man. He's not eating a peanut.
No.
Maybe he doesn't like it.
He's posing.
If I put it on a triangle, he'd probably eat it.
Maybe.
Don't eat my triangle.
What are they applauding him for? What about me? Nobody ever cares about me. No, it's always some dumb animal that people care about. A cat is lost right now, and you should see how upset everybody is. Well, what's so nice about a cat? Just because it's soft and purrs and likes to drink milk. Ugh. I like things that are ugly and awful. And that claw around and frighten people like a worm.
So we're going to play a game, and we're going to look down on things, familiar things that we see all the time, and we're going to try to see what they would look like if we looked down on them. Now, you're going to wait until I call on you so we give the children at home a chance to guess too, okay? Mm-hmm. Everybody got it?
That's
good. All right, now, look at this card for a minute. Okay. What does that look like? Fourth.
Top of a house.
Oh, let's see. All right.
He didn't give us a chance.
Yeah, I said I'll call on you. He got it. Okay.
He's a different card?
No. That looks like a jigsaw puzzle to me. Okay, Kevin.
Trees. How much trees?
A whole bunch of trees. What do you think, Oriana?
Just one tree.
Just one tree. Ah, see? It's just one tree.
I didn't get it right.
Okay, now, let's try this one.
Who goes?
Kevin.
Car.
Car, right. Why was that easier to see?
When I'm at home, I look over my car.
Yeah, you have little play model cars.
Okay. Yeah, I have one, a real one.
There it is. There's that car. Okay. Let's look at that. That looks like a ladybug to me.
A ladybug?
You know what a ladybug is?
Yeah, we collect them.
What's that look like to you, Ford?
A bus.
A bus. Whoops! We missed it.
Shh!
He's right. There it is.
I wonder what the next one is.
Now that looks like a pretty design to me.
Oh, I know.
Wait a minute. Oriana.
Street lights.
The traffic lights. Right. What's this up here?
That's so like they stick in to the side, that's all they don't fall down.
Huh?
They stick inside.
That's the top. See? Right there. That's the top. See?
Oh,
it comes to a point.
Was.
What? What did you think it was?
This thing in the middle of the traffic. I didn't think it was.
No, it's the kind on the, it's not the hanging street light, it's the kind on the post.
Yeah. That's what I meant, but I didn't know.
Yeah, traffic light, street light. Not street light, traffic light. A street lamp is, that lights up the way. Now, to me that looks like a tire. What's that look like to you? Ford? A lamp? Does that look like a lamp to you, Oriana?
Not to me.
Doesn't to me either,
it like
but it is.
What's
this? What's this part here?
That's a light bulb.
What's this?
That holds the light bulb.
It sits on top of the light bulb. It holds a lamp shade. Okay. Ariana?
A chair?
Yeah. What do you think, Kevin?
Grandpa's seat?
Teeth. Teeth. Excuse me. Okay, she's right. It is a chair. Look at that. See?
Grandpa's teeth.
Yeah, I thought these were teeth. Those look like teeth to me. But that's the back of the chair. Well, that's just a different way of looking at things. You know, speaking of different ways of looking at things.
Hey, Jim!
What is it, buddy?
Jim, I got the windows for the holes in the wall.
Good boy. Are you sure you got the right one?
Oh, yeah, Jim. I got a square window for the square hole in the wall and a round window for the round hole in the wall. What's the matter? You don't think the old buddy knows what he's doing?
We'll soon find out.
All right.
Let me see this window. Just bring it right over to the
wall. That's it.
Uh-oh.
What's the matter, Jim?
Wait a minute? There's something wrong here.
Something wrong?
What shape is that hole in the wall?
Jim, that's a square hole in the wall.
And what shape is the window you bought for it?
That's a round window, Jim.
Come over here.
Okay.
What shape is that hole in the wall?
Jim, that's a round hole in the wall.
And what shape is the window you bought for it?
That's a square window I bought. Jim, what are we going to do now, Jim?
I've got an idea.
Good boy.
Pick up this window.
Hey, Jim, what you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing? I'm trying to bend this square window so it'll fit into the round hole in the wall.
Ha ha, good idea, Jim.
Hold it.
What is it?
If I do that, the glass might break.
Oh, that's a bad idea, you got to tell, Jim. What are we going to do now?
There's only one sensible thing to do.
Uh-huh.
I'll have to saw out the whole wall. And then I'll lift up the wall and I'll turn it all the way around until the square hole is on that side and the round hole is on that side. Whew. But that'll probably take me all day long. All day, because that's the biggest wall in our room. And this never would have happened, buddy, if you had gotten the right windows for the right holes in the wall. Boy, oh boy.
Hey, Jim! Surprise!
What's this surprise?
Hey, Jim, when I was at the hardware store, I couldn't remember exactly which window was which, you know, so I got another pair of windows exactly the opposite, see? So, look, hold that. Now I got a square window for the square hole, huh? And I got a round window for the round hole in the wall. So, square window for the square hole in the wall, round window for the round hole in the wall, and even got two round windows that we don't even need.
You can't do anything right.
What are we gonna do now, Jim?
I think I can figure this one out.
Yeah? Come on, Jim.
All we'll have to do is to take the two wrong windows back to the store where we got them, and then I'll get my money back.
You did it again, Jim.
Of course I did it again. Now let's take the wrong windows and let's go to the store. Come on, buddy.
Boy, take the wrong windows right back to the store and get our money back. Boy, that Jim sure is smart. Wish I was as smart as Jim.
Cat! Yoo-hoo! Cat! Come out! I have a surprise for you if you come out.
Big Bird!
Oh!
What kind of surprise you have for the cat?
If I tell you, it won't be a surprise.
Oh, come on, Big Bird. You can tell me. Tell me.
I have a bag full of marshmallows for the cat.
Oh, but Big Bird, cats don't eat marshmallows.
They don't?
No.
Everybody loves marshmallows. I love marshmallows.
Well, then why don't you eat them?
Well, wouldn't you like to eat them?
Okay, I'll have some.
Some? What does that mean?
Well, Big Bird, if I took the whole bag, then I'd have all of them.
You?
If I only took some out of the bag, then there'd be some left over for you.
Oh. Well, show me.
Okay. See? I have some.
I have some.
Right.
Oh, that's good. I have some and you have some. Let's try that again.
Okay.
Now, let me see. I have some, and if I eat some... And I eat some more. And then I eat... Oh, dear. Oh, dear. I've eaten all the marshmallows. And now I have them all, and you have none.
And what do you have, Big Bird?
I have a stomach ache.
Big Bird's a little unhappy, but he'll be okay soon. I'll tell you how a lot of people get unhappy, and things turn out okay, when I read you this story about Sam. Now, Sam's a little boy. Wanted to do a lot of playing and things. And here he is. Sam wanted to play. Everyone in his house was busy, and no one wanted to play with him. Sam walked into the kitchen, where his mother was peeling apples for pie. He picked up a knife from the table. "Sam, don't touch that knife," cried his mother. "That knife is very sharp, too sharp for little boys. I don't ever want to see you touch that knife again." Sam's mother went back to peeling apples. "Why don't you go outside and play, Sammy?" Sam walked out on the porch. His big brother George was sitting on the steps, reading his books from school. Sam picked up a book and turned the pages to find a picture. "Sam, put down that book," yelled George. "That's my book, and you're not to touch it." Poor Sam looked as if he might cry. "That's a book I got from school," said George, not quite so loud as before. "If you get it dirty or rip the pages, I'll be in trouble. Don't ever touch my books again, understand?" Sam just sort of stood there. "Why don't you go inside and play, Sammy?" said George. Sam went into the living room. And there by the window, his big sister Marcia was making clothes for her paper dolls. Sam picked up one of the dolls and waved its hand up and down. "Sam," screamed Marcia when she saw what he was doing, "you'll bend my doll's hand. You'll ruin her." Sam looked as if he might cry. "You go play somewhere else, Sammy, but don't ever touch my dolls again." Sam just stood there. "Why don't you go find Daddy?" said Marcia. Sam's father was sitting at his desk, reading the newspaper. Sam stood beside him for a minute. Then, ping, Sam punched down a key on the typewriter. "Sam, get your hands off that typewriter," shouted his father. "How many times must I tell you that typewriter is not a toy for children? Typewriters are very easy to break and they cost lots of money to fix. Don't ever touch my typewriter again." Sam's father turned back to his newspaper. "Why don't you go find Mother?" he said. Then Sam really did cry. He sat right down on the floor by his father's desk, and he cried and cried and cried. He cried so loud that his mother came in from the kitchen, and his big brother George came in from the porch, and his big sister Marcia came in from the living room. "What in the world is the matter with Sam?" asked his father. "I think I know," said his mother, sitting down in the rocking chair by the desk and picking up Sam in her arms. "I think I know, too," said George. "I think I know, too," said Marcia. For a minute, everyone was quiet. The rocking chair creaked back and forth as Sam curled in his mother's arms. "Sammy," said his mother, "if you're not too busy, there's a job you could do for me in the kitchen. Well, Sam was tired of crying, so he followed his mother into the kitchen. His father and his big sister and his big brother all came along, too. Sam's mother pulled out a tall kitchen stool so he could reach the table. Then she pinned a dish towel around his neck so he wouldn't get dirty. And then she gave him a piece of soft pie dough and a rolling pin so he could roll the dough out flat. There's just enough dough to fit in this little pan, said Sam's mother. Maybe you can make a tart to bake in the oven with the pie. Say, that's a good job for Sam, said his father. He's not too little, said his sister. And he's not too big, said his brother. In fact, said his mother, he's just the right size. And now, Sammy, what kind of jam would you like for your tart? Raspberry, said Sam. How about that? You know, I bet another thing that Sam does is studies his words. And in order to know words, you have to know letters. Letters like the letter J.
What's happening, man?
I don't know.
What's that?
I don't know. Looks like a fishhook.
It's not a fishhook. It's a J.
A what?
The letter J. Like to hear a story about the letter J, boys?
Yes.
Once upon a time, a guy named Joe noticed a June bug on his toe. Put it in a jar and started to go. But here come the judge and said, no, no, no. So Joe said why and started to jump and dance a jig on an old tree stump. Then jogged along to the city dump where he jammed the June bug in a tire pump. Then the judge caught up and started to wail and said to Joe, justice will prevail. Then the jury met and set the bail and Joe got an hour in the city jail.
So that's the letter J.
It still looks like a fish hook.
You know what else we learned?
Yeah, don't jive a judge by jamming a June bug.
Don't ever forget that. Don't jive a judge by jamming a June bug. Hey, here's something I teach in high school science. This is a magnet that I have in my hand. It's a piece of metal, a special piece of metal, and it picks up other pieces of metal, just like that. And these over here are little iron filings. They're ground-up type metal. See, it picks them up and holds them. Now, this is a small magnet, and with a small magnet, you can pick up small pieces of metal, but with a big magnet,
you know, Gordon, I sort of like taking care of this store.
You like it, huh?
Yeah, it's fun for
me. Hey, Bob, listen, you ought to have been with me today.
Why is that?
I was walking down the street looking for the cat.
Yeah?
Right? Couldn't find the cat, and I ran into Mr. Cardwell. You know him, right?
Sure.
All of a sudden, he starts pulling triangles out of the air.
Come
all
on,
over the
you're
place.
Putting
yeah,
that.
Behind. Oh, you should have. All over Sesame Street.
He found all these on
found
the
all of them. You ever see anything like that? A whole bunch
that's
of triangles.
That's really crazy. You know, I'll bet you anything that I could find some triangles hidden right here in Mr. Hooper's store.
You're kidding me, Bob.
Nope.
You're going to find triangles just
I'll
like
find
Mr.
you
Cardwell
some triangles now. Just like Mr. Cardwell right here in yeah. the store. Can I borrow these for a while?
Help yourself.
They all have three sides, haven't they?
And three corners.
All right. This is the first one, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, no, that won't good.
Uh-huh. One piece of pie.
Good one. That's a triangle.
That's a triangle.
Right about that.
Now, let's see. Here's another one. A little smaller, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, circle.
What do you have?
An ice cream cone.
That's a triangle?
That is a triangle.
You know, you're right.
How about that?
That's two. Go for another.
Now, here's another one. That's a different shape. Nothing on the telephone. Houses have triangles.
Where?
Right at the top of their roof. How's that?
That's three. That's not
mm-hmm.
bad.
That's three.
That's pretty good.
Now we've got a big one here, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Nope.
Pretty fine.
I just happen to have a pine tree right
you
here.
Just happen just to have a pine tree.
Just happen to have a pine tree.
But
that's
it. That's, though.
That's yeah. It's
another one.
That's another one. Here's another one. Nope. Nothing there. One, two, three.
You found a triangle on the bridge.
Triangle on the bridge.
I never found anything but a bridge.
There's a lot of triangles all over this bridge here.
Yeah.
Now, here's two of the same size. That may be a little tougher. Except the front of a tent.
Yeah.
One. Two triangles on the front of the tent.
Whoa.
Put them together and one big triangle.
Okay.
Okay? You're how still, am I doing?
You're not doing bad. You have one left
one
in your
left.
Hand.
Okay.
See what you can do with it.
Nope.
No good. That's
nothing
the
there.
Car.
Ha!
You found it.
I found it. The front of the arrow.
I'm telling you, found
how's
another
that?
Triangle.
Perfect. Huh? Right there.
Okay. You ready? One more for you.
One more?
Right.
Easy. I'll find it.
You can handle this?
I'll find it. Give me a minute.
See what you can find.
All right. Nope. I've got it. I've got it.
A book?
Here's
no,
my triangle.
No, no, no. It won't
it
work.
Is. It is.
No,
it
won't
is.
Work.
It
book
is.
Has four sides.
Ah, that way, but watch. Now, would you mind placing the triangle right on the front of the book?
Hmm.
And now what do we have?
You have a triangle. You win.
There. Mm-hmm. It's done. It's done. Hey, Bert, it's done.
Yeah?
Come on. Hey, Bert, it's done.
Well, what's done?
The story I just wrote.
Story?
Greatest story in the whole wide world.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, let me read it to you.
Well, is it going to take long?
Oh, no, it's just a short story, Bert.
All right, read it to me.
Okay, you're going to love this story. It's the greatest story in the world.
Yeah, just read it to me, Ernie.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Here it comes. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Now comes the sad part. H, I, J, K.
Ernie.
L, M, N, O.
Ernie.
P. Here, now listen to this. This is the action part that starts now.
Yeah.
Q, R, S, T.
Ernie, that's
U.
the alphabet.
Oh, but listen to the wind up. V, W, X, Y,
Well?
Well, what?
Well, finish it. Go ahead. You went U, V, W, X, Y, and you stopped there. Go ahead, finish it.
What? And tell you how the story ends? Then you'll never want to read it.
Well, one of these things is not like the other. One of these things just doesn't belong. Can you tell which thing is not like the other before I finish my song? Here's a cookie, an orange, a sandwich, and a comic book. One of these things is different. Well, if you guessed this thing is not like the other, if you guessed this thing doesn't belong, if you guessed this thing is not like the others, well, then you know you're absolutely right, because this is a book, and you can read a book, and all the rest of the things are things that you can eat. A cookie, an orange, and a sandwich. I have four more things now that are here, and one of these are different. See how you do on this one. Well, one of these things is not like the other. One of these things doesn't belong. Can you tell which thing is not like the other before I finish my song? Here's a nice hat, a shoe, an orange, and a glove. Well, if you guessed this thing is not like the others, if you guessed this thing just doesn't belong, if you guessed this thing is not like the others, then you're absolutely right again, because this is an orange, and you can eat an orange, and all the rest of the things, the shoe, the hat, and the glove, are things to wear. I've got one more for you. Well, one of these things is not like the other. One of these things just doesn't belong. One of these things is not like the other. Can you tell which one? There's a nice car, a bus, a dump truck, and a shoe. Well, if you guessed this thing is not like the others, if you guessed this thing just doesn't belong, if you guessed this thing is not like the others, then, my friends, you're right once again, because this is a shoe, and you can wear a shoe, but all of these things are things to ride in, the truck, the car, and the bus. We've been talking about fours of things, one, two, three, four. So let's have a message from the number four right now.
Kitty? Kitty? Here, Kitty. Kitty?
Is there a cat lost on Sesame Street?
Yes, that's right, there is.
Well, then we'll help you find it.
Will you help, really?
Yes, certainly.
Okay,
now, since
how are you going to do it?
Well, I'll tell you.
All right,
now, since
listen.
Cats like to chase mice,
mm-hmm.
Today we'll all be mice.
You're going to be mice?
Yes, okay, gang, we're mice today.
Mice today.
Get ready.
Okay, let me help out.
Okay.
Since you're going to help me, I'll help you.
Good.
Here's a pair of mouse ears.
A pair of mouse ears.
Terrific mouse ears. Look
a out. Pair of mouse ears, gang. Okay, get them on. Okay, next.
And mouse nose and mouse whiskers.
Mouse nose and mouse whiskers. Hey, mouse nose and mouse whiskers.
Where's my nose?
Whiskers.
And a pair of mouse glasses.
Mouse glasses, guys. Ready? Come on up.
Those. Hey, that's nice.
You,
look, there's one, two, three of you. How about singing a chorus of Three Blind Mice just to warm up?
No, we can't do that.
No?
We can't
Why?
Sing Three Blind Mice.
Why?
Because there are four of us.
Oh, there are four of you.
Mm-hmm.
One, two, three, four. Okay. How about singing Four Blind Mice?
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
You like that? Okay. Are you ready?
All ready.
Four blind mice.
four blind mice. See how they run. See how they run. They four blind the fighters wipe. Cause they're blind the fighting knife. Have you ever seen such a sight in your life? The four blind they run. They all ran after the farmer's wife, who caught up their gun with a carving knife. Have you ever seen such a sight in your life? The four blind they run. They all ran after the farmer's wife. See, they're blind with a farming knife. Have you ever seen such a sight in your life? They all ran after the farmer's wife, who caught up their dad with a carving knife. Have you ever seen such a sight in your life? There's four blind mice.
Come in.
Good morning.
Hi, Mr. Cardwell. What are you doing delivering groceries?
Well, Mr. Hooper's away today, so Bob and I are helping out at the store.
Oh, that's nice of you. Listen, I have my list right here, so let me check everything. Let's see, I ordered carrots. Five carrots. One, two, three, four. That's only four, Mr. Cardwell.
Is that only four?
Yeah.
Oh, there's the other one right behind your hair.
And five.
What's the next item on the list?
Lemons.
Lemons.
Five lemons.
Oh, yes.
Two lemons? Oh.
Yes. I'll count for you.
Sure. Oh, okay.
One,
two, three, four. That's only four. I ordered five.
Oh, and there's five.
Five. Okay. And lollipops now. I ordered some lollipops for the kids. I ordered five lollipops, you know. One, two, three. That's only four again, Mr. Carter.
Oh, well, there it is again, right behind your hair.
Uh-huh. And five.
I think the last item was eggs, wasn't
it? Yes, eggs. I did order eggs. I ordered five eggs, you know. One, two, three, four.
Well, chickens lay eggs. Let me see if I can make a chicken appear. Let's see.
Chicken appear.
You snap. You snap our hands. And we look inside. And there's the chicken.
But, Mr. Cardwell, I didn't order a chicken. I just want another egg.
Well, chickens lay eggs. There's the fifth egg.
And five. Thank you very much.
Well, goodbye.
Goodbye? But, Mr. Cardwell, you forgot your
bye-bye
chicken.
Now.
Come here.
Here, cat.
You hear that? Here, cat. Come, cat. Does anybody bother to ask Oscar? No, but it doesn't do any good. I wouldn't tell him anything anyway.
You wouldn't tell anybody what, Oscar?
I wouldn't tell anybody anything about anything.
By the way, you haven't seen a...
A cat? No, I haven't seen a cat, if that's what you're gonna ask.
Well, then you didn't see which way it went.
No, I especially didn't see him crawl under the fence a while ago.
You didn't?
No, and I didn't see him go across the vacant lot, either.
I didn't see him go across the vacant lot.
And I especially didn't see him go down into that empty building down the street. And I didn't see him go into Hooper's drain pipe behind his building, either. Wait a minute. I haven't told you anything, have I?
No, 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 not a thing. Not a thing.
Good. The last thing I'd want to do is be a help to anybody.
Behind the drain pipe, Mr. Hooper's store. Go down there and check that.
Nobody gets any information from Oscar the Grouch if Oscar the Grouch doesn't want to tell it.
Oh, dear, I can't do anything.
Oh, what's the matter?
Oh, Susan, I've been looking all day for the cat, and I can't find him.
Oh, well, don't feel bad, because we've been looking all day, too. We couldn't find it.
Oh, I even asked a funny-looking little bird, but all it kept saying was meow.
What bird said meow?
A little bird with pointed ears and a long tail and whiskers.
Big Bird, that was the cat.
Oh?
It certainly was, Big Bird. And here is the lost cat of Sesame Street. See it, Susan?
Oh, good heavens!
Big Bird! Big Bird's just a cat.
I just remembered. Birds are supposed to be afraid of cats.
Oh, don't be afraid.
But not this one, Big Bird.
This one won't hurt you.
It won't?
No. Come on over here and meet it.
Well, I don't know.
Well, look, Big Bird, I'll tell you what. I'll make you keeper of the cats on Sesame Street.
You will?
Yeah, you'll be keeper of all the cats on Sesame Street.
Hey, I'm looking for the keeper of the cats on Sesame Street.
You are?
That's me.
Well, we just happen to have the keeper of the cats right here, just newly appointed.
Are you the keeper of the cats, Big Bird?
Yes, Gordon says so.
Well, then you'd better know something about cats, right?
Yes.
Okay. Hey, we've got five of them right here. These are little baby cats.
Oh.
Do you know what baby cats are called?
Yes, they're ducklings.
No, ducklings are baby ducks.
Puppies.
Puppies? No, puppies are baby dogs. Oh. Baby cats are called kittens.
Oh.
See how nice and soft they are?
Yes, what are they eating?
They're eating milk and some cat food. Would you like to feel this one? See how nice and soft he is?
Well, okay.
Go ahead.
Oh, he has nice feathers.
No, you have feathers, Big Bird. This is called fur.
Oh.
Kittens have fur. See how nice and soft they are?
I know. I'm going to teach them how to fly.
Well, no, you can't teach cats to fly, Big Bird. That's just birds.
I'll teach them how to lay eggs then.
Look, I don't know whether Big Bird's going to teach the cats how to fly or lay eggs or build nests or what, but I do know that we'll all be back here on Sesame Street. So you make a point out of coming back and joining us, okay?
I'm going to teach them how to dig worms.
Goodbye.
No, they don't like
worms. I'm going to teach them.
Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letters S, W, and J, and by the numbers 4 and 5.
I'm going to teach them how to chirp then.
Chirp, chirp.
The book Sam read on today's show was written by Anne Herbert Scott. Drawings by Symeon Shimon, published by McGraw-Hill. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.